Hello, folks. HelpNDoc makes it easy to create image maps that allow readers to click on regions of an image to access hyperlinks. An image map can be used to document parts of a screenshot, a photograph, or a roadmap, for example, by allowing readers to click parts of the image to access greater details about it. You will need to first access the image map editor, and you can access it two ways. You can click Add Item in the Library group on the Home Ribbon tab. Now select Add Image Map from the drop-down menu. Or right-click in the Library panel to display a pop-up menu. Hover over Add Item, then select Add Image Map from the sub-menu. Using either of the two methods to access the image map editor will display the Insert an Item into the Library window. First, enter the name of the image map in the Library Item Name text box. This name is what will be displayed in your library panel. As you are creating this image map for the first time, there is no image file attached to this image map. To include a file for this image map, click the No File Included link, and then select Include File from the pop-up menu. The Windows file browser will now display for you to navigate to the file you wish to use for this image map. After you have located the file, select the file, and then click the Open button. The No File Included link will now change to a One File Included link, confirming you have successfully added the image file. To begin editing the image map, click the Update Image Map button. The Image Map Editor window will now display. The image you selected previously is now displayed in the window. It is now possible to add shapes on it using the Create Shapes group. Here, you have access to three possible shapes you can use on the image map. Selecting either of the standard rectangle or circle shapes, you can simply click the image to place the selected shape onto the image, and then adjust the size and position as needed. Or click the upper left-hand point of the region, and while holding down your cursor, pull downward to the right to select the area as needed. Then release your mouse. Using the more advanced polygon shape feature, click the first point of the region, and then drag your mouse to the second point, and click the image again. Repeat this process to define the desired shape. Double-click the last point to close the shape. Upon the successful creation of a shape, your shape then changes into a red shape, highlighting the clickable region. This highlighted region is not displayed to readers. It is displayed here only to help you define the regions. You can now use the sizing handles to expand and collapse the region, or enter a value here in the boxes to the right in the Properties panel to adjust the size or position of a rectangle or circle. Now, to add a hyperlink to the region, select the shape for which you'd like to add or change the hyperlink for. Then click the Click to Change link in the Properties panel next to Link 2. This opens the Edit Hyperlink window. Use this window to define the hyperlink. This is the location to which readers will be taken to when they click on the region just defined. Editing hyperlinks is outlined in another video. Next, enter a name for the region in the title text box. This name is displayed as a hint when the user hovers over that specific shape. When you're done creating your region on your image map, click the OK button. This closes the image map editor window and returns you to the Insert an Item into the Library window. Click OK here to save the image map and close the window. To use the image map in your project, click it in the Library panel and drag it to the place you'd like to use it in your project. When you release your mouse, the image map is dropped into that location. To update an image map, double-click it in the Library panel, or double-click the image map anywhere it appears in your project. HelpNDoc is free for personal use and evaluation purposes. You can download it at helpndoc.com and see other video guides at helpndoc.com/online-help. Thanks for watching.